Hi friends, I'm Sharvari Sane from Electrical Department. Today we are going to solve the problem which is based on the three-phase supply. A 450 hertz three-phase voltage is applied to the three star connected impedances. Each impedance consists of resistance of 15 ohm, capacitance of 177 microfarad and inductance of 0.1 Henry in series. Find number 1 phase current, number 2 line current, number 3 power drop, and number 4 power factor, 5 reactive power, 6 total KVA, and draw neat phasor diagram. Now, while studying this particular problem, it is very clear that it is a combination of R, L, and C. So first of all, we'll try to draw the figure for the same. It is a star connection with the three values. So, resistance, inductance and capacitance. It is in star. So for all three phases, the same values will be there. So resistance, inductance and capacitance. And the same here for the third phase. So this will be my R, this will be my XL, and this will be my XC. We'll write down the given values first. So the first one, it is a supply voltage which is VL, which is equal to 415 volt, frequency 50 hertz. Resistance per phase, which is provided to us, which is 15 ohm. Capacitance is 177 microfarad. And inductance L is given 0.1 Henry. As it is a R, L and C circuit, so first of all, we'll calculate the value of the impedance. Before that, we'll just note down the things which is supposed to calculate in this problem. So it will be number 1 is the line current, number 2 is the phase current, number 3 is a power, number 4 it is a power factor, so indirectly it is nothing but the cos theta. Then it is a reactive power, so it is a Q. Total KVA, so it is apparent power. And finally, the value. By using this value, we have to draw the phasor for the same. In the first step, it is necessary to calculate the value of the impedance, and the impedance is a per phase, so it will be ZPH. It will be nothing but R plus or minus JX. Now X will be the difference between the XL or XC, or XC minus XL, whichever be the maximum. For that part, it is necessary to calculate the value of XL and XC separately. First of all, we'll calculate the value of XL, which is equal to 2πfL. Substituting the values which are provided to us, which is equal to 2 into pi, frequency is 50 hertz and inductance value is 0.1 Henry. If we will multiply all these factors, we will be getting XL is equal to 31.42 ohms. Next part, it is a XC. So XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi F and C. Again, substituting the value for XC, which is equal to 1 upon 2 pi, frequency is 50 hertz. And the capacitance is given 177 microfarad, it means that it is nothing but 10 raised to minus 6. After calculation this part, we'll be getting the value of 17.98 ohms. Now we have the value of Xc, which is equal to 1 upon 2 pi Fc, and the value which is calculated, it is 17.98, and XL, which is equal to 31.42. It is very clear from the value is that XL is greater than Xc. So I can write the formula for the impedance, that is ZPH is equal to R plus J XL minus Xc. So it will be coming 15, which is only given to us, J XL, which is calculated 31.42 minus Xc, which is 17.98, and we'll be getting the value for the ZPH, which is equal to 15 plus J 30.44. This is the rectangular form of ZPH of our circuit. Now if you convert it into the equivalent polar form, it will be 20.14 with the angle 41.86 ohms. Now it is always to be remembered that whatever be the angle associated with the impedance is nothing but the power factor angle of that circuit. So cos theta is nothing but the power factor, and that angle theta is 41.86 degrees. And in the previous page, we already derived the equation for the ZPH, which is equal to 20.14 with the angle 41.86, and the cos theta, which is calculated power factor, and that is nothing but theta is equal to 41.86. Now we can calculate the value of cos theta, which is equal to cos of 41.86. Now the next part, it is, as it is a star connection, VL is equal to root 3 times VPH and IL is equal to IPH. We have been given the supply voltage VL, which is 415 volt. So we can calculate the value of VPH, which is equal to VL upon root 3. This is coming 415 volts divided by root 3. So it is coming 239.6. Now next part, it is a IPH. As we have the value of VPH and the ZPH with us, so we can directly calculate the value of IPH, which is ZPH, which is equal to 239.6 and 20.14, which is coming approximately 11.9 ampere. Now the next part is IL. As it is a star connection, IL is equal to IPH, so again it will be 11.9 ampere. It has been asked to calculate all type of the powers, so step by step we'll write down the formulas and substitute the values. So active power, which is equal to root 3 VL IL cos theta. So active power is equal to root 3 into 415 into current is 11.9, and cos theta, which is nothing but cos of 41.86. So this value is becoming almost 6.37 kilowatts. So active power is 6.37 kilowatts. Next part, it is a reactive power. The formula which is provided to us, it is root 3 VL IL sin theta. Value of theta is known to us, so again we'll substitute the values. So root 3 into 415 into 11.9 and sine of 41.86, which is coming approximately 5.71 kVAr. Last part, it is S, which is equal to root 3 VL IL. So it will be root 3 into 415 into 11.9. It is coming 8.55 kVA. So here we have completed our numerical part, which is nothing but the calculations of the voltages. So VPH is equal to 239.6 volt, IPH which is equal to 11.9, as IL is equal to IPH, so it is the same. Active power, it is 6.37 kilowatt. The reactive power is 5.71 kVAr. And apparent power, finally, it is 8.55 kVA. The last part of this problem is to draw the phasor diagram. For drawing the phasor diagram, we need the certain values in magnitude as well as certain angles. So these values are nothing but the voltage which is given to us, which is VL 415 volt, VPH which is equal to 239.6 volt, IL as well as IPH, which both are same, and it is 11.9. Now while drawing the phasor diagram, the care should be taken that we have to take the appropriate values and the scale for the same and draw the phasor diagram. As it is, this diagram is drawn for the star connection. First of all, we'll draw for the phase voltages, and from that we'll develop the line voltages with respect to their currents. It has been observed that in this problem the value of XL, it is greater than XC. So even though the capacitance is present into the circuit, it is that the circuit is becoming inductive than capacitive. So the power factor is lagging, and that power factor is 41.86. So we'll draw the phasor for the same. This is for the VR as a reference. Approximately 120 degree apart from that, it is a VY, and again 120 degree apart from that, it is a VB. This angle is 120, 120, 120. Now as the power factor which is given, or we have calculated from the figure, that the angle of cos theta or theta, which is 41.86. So it is an inductive circuit, so the current is lagging to the voltage by 41.86 degree. So this will be my IR, which is lagging by 41.86 degree. It will be similar for remaining two phases. So it will be IY, angle is 41.86. And here also, it is lagging by 41.86. Now by using this part, we can draw the parallelogram or we can show the line voltages directly. If we want to show by parallelogram, we can select one of the phase from that and complete the parallelogram. In this problem, I am taking the value as a Vy, so I want to draw for the Ry. So I have taken the reflected component of Vy with the same value, and by using the parallelogram, so I can draw this part. In the parallelogram is showing the resultant of Vry. As R is a real component and Y is a reflected component, so I have taken Vry. Angle between them total will be 60, so it will be 30 degrees. So similarly, we can plot for Vyb, we can draw for Vbr. So this is nothing but the complete phasor diagram for this problem. Thank you very much.